Hello everyone and welcome back to the channel. Today we're here with another review. Today we're gonna have a look at the Papo Brachiosaurus figure. His product code, as you can see right here on the Papo catalog, is 55030, the Papo Brachiosaurus. We're talking about a figure with about 31 centimeters in height and about 34 centimeters in length. The Papo Brachiosaurus is the largest, heaviest and most expensive Papo figure so far. It is a thing of beauty and I highly recommend you guys check this guy out. It should not miss from any collection. It may be a little bit more expensive than the other Papo figures, but of course you get how big this one is, and it's actually pretty heavy too. It feels great on your hand. It's also very nice for decoration purposes as well. So let's have a closer look to this one. First, as far as the head goes, let's remove the Papo label from the top of from the head. Okay, so here we are. There it is. You can see how nicely sculpted the head area is. The same and the mouth, very nicely painted as well. And the teeth, you don't see any sloppiness at all. Here isn't from the other part. Beautiful sculpted and painted. All of it. I really love the coloration that they use for this figure. This gray coloration, you know, which looks fantastic. It pretty. This Brachiosaurus is actually the one that we saw on the Jurassic Park one, when which actually the first dinosaur that they see when they arrive. So I think it looks fantastic. This thing is a masterpiece, a thing of beauty, I would say. Everything on this figure is perfect. I will give it a 10 out of 10. I really like the way that they have sculpted the head. You can also see all this nice skin folding and details on the neck area. How nicely sculpted is the entire thing. It's actually very hard to see, to hold it. It's actually a very heavy model. And you can see, Look how beautiful this one is. You can see all this nice musculature right here on the chest area, on the shoulders, on the biceps. Fantastic. Highly detailed and very nicely colored and painted. I really love this mix of colors that Papo used on this. And as you can see on the top of it, it has this some sort of a glossiness, you know, to make it look shine. You know? Fantastic. And look how big this one is next to my hand. It really is amazing, an amazing figure. And they also sculpted the underneath part of the feet. And here on the belly you can see the Papo label. It says Papo 2012, made in China. Again, all of these details that you can see on the body is fantastic. Very beautiful, very nice sculpture on this figure. The best Brachiosaurus, in my opinion, that you can find outside there. I'm a huge fan of Papo, and especially the dinosaur line. I think they're from the best that you can find outside there, on a very reasonable price. And for the quality that you actually get, this thing is full of plastic, you know, and very good material that Papo uses. So I would highly recommend you get this one if you haven't already. It might be a little bit more expensive, as far as it may be worth the price of two figures, but it will be worth it. So, fantastic. And let me show you once again the feet. Look how beautiful they are. And they have also this grey coloration applied on the nails. You can see all the details right here on the down part of the feet. And from the inside. I also love the way that they have made from this grey coloration get into this brownies that it has for the underneath part of his belly and his neck. So Papo really knows how to choose his colors for their figures. It also has some dark brownies, you know, dark or actually I would say dark gray coloration, you know, on some spots on the dinosaur to highlight the details. And you can also see the ribs area right here. The back of the Brachiosaurus is very nicely sculpted too. Fantastic, fantastic. And the tail is actually pretty, you know, hard. You know, you can keep the entire thing from here. Maybe on the tail, on the head is a little bit softer as far as plastic goes, but yeah, you can understand how good quality this thing is by the way you are touching it on your hand. So, like I said, this is the largest figure from Papo and the most expensive. It's also the tallest of every dinosaur that they have produced so far, and I think it should stay this way. For a size comparison next to the Papo Apatosaurus, this one is longer, but it's way close to his height. And next to the Papo Amargasaurus, which is the third, you know, long-necked dinosaur that Papo line has produced, I think he's the smallest of them all. I would like to see Papo producing more long-necked dinosaurs, some different species, you know. An Agustina would be okay, or a Miragaia, you know, just different species, you know. Also next to the Papo Parasaurolophus, the classic Papo T-Rex, the Giganotosaurus, that is actually a very tall model. You can see how much the Brachiosaurus outscales him. Also the Papo Therizinosaurus, the Papo Baryonyx, and the Papo Spinosaurus. And next to the Papo Pentaceratops, this Brachiosaurus also reminds me the one, except from the one that you saw on the Jurassic Park or the Jurassic World movies, because we saw Brachiosaurus and there. It also reminds me the one that we saw from the Disney cartoon movie, with the Disney dinosaurs, with the Aladar, which was an Iguanodon. So here it is, next to the Papo Iguanodon, which also reminds me a lot of the Aladar figure. And of course the other characters of this movie, which was a Styracosaurus. Here it is, and an Ankylosaurus, like this one. So I think you can have a nice diorama with all of them as well. And you can see how the difference on the scale. So these were, guys, the Papo Brachiosaurus figure. Highly recommend you guys this one. So, thanks for watching the video. Hope you enjoyed it and I helped you out. I'm gonna see you next time. Bye.